Blue Heron Bridge, Singer Island, Florida, deploying the OPFLEX eelgrass with the OPFLEX dive team. One, two, three. Yes! Those were 6 feet of change. We did the calculations properly. Thank you, Greg Curtis. We did the buoyancy calculations properly. Get your ass down here with James Cameron's sub now.
Greg Curtis, and along with Scott Smith, we developed this concept of synthetic eelgrass to take advantage of the oleophilic nature of EMA in order to capture oil on the water. Now, eelgrass is an analog to natural eelgrass, and it rises up from the bottom and floats on the top of the water, providing a surface area that the oil can adhere to. Because it comes up from the bottom, it isn't just floating on the surface. It captures oil that's in the water column as well.
Water contamination problems. We're going to fingerprint the water column, and we're going to test for bioaccumulation also with the OPFLEX environmental indicator technology.
We have the technology with OPFLEX to remove the oil at the source of contamination and prevent our waterways from being destroyed.
BP recycled and reused the OPFLEX an average of 20 to 30 times at the Deepwater Horizon site in the Gulf of Mexico and at the decontamination center in Lake Charles.
OPFLEX technology is not just about cleaning up oil disasters. OPFLEX technology is about preventing the waterways from being contaminated with oil and other contaminants. Everything that gets spilled on a daily basis throughout this country. I have been able to create the most effective products by being on the ground. It's all about being in front of the people doing the work in real world conditions. Essentially, I've been able to create the best products because my laboratory is the actual real world with everyday oil spill disasters, whether it's BP, stormwater runoff, or contamination in the Port of New Bedford.